Millions of people around the world get a kick out of watching a soccer player stop on a dime and turn in the other direction with the ball. We love to watch a basketball or football player make a cut so quickly that it leaves the defender falling to the ground. An acrobat who can twirl one way and then another in a fraction of a second leaves us spellbound. As impressive as these feats are, the airborne maneuvers of bats make the greatest athletes in the world look average at best. Bats are quite unique, being the only flying mammals on Earth. Depending on the species, many bats look like rodents with wings, really cool wings. A bat's arms and long bony fingers are covered with a thin membrane made of muscles. Their hands are built into their wings. How cool is that? Whereas the wings of birds are rather stiff, bats can easily and quickly change the shape of their wings simply by moving their flexible fingers. Bats' bendable wings are remarkably designed, allowing for what two evolutionary scientists admit are complex movements of each wing stroke in overall flight speed, body position, and angle of attack. Evolutionists who have carefully studied bat flight for years admit that bat wings are highly articulated with more than two dozen independent joints and a thin, flexible membrane covering them. Birds and insects can fold and rotate their wings during flight, but bats have many more options. Their flexible skin can catch the air and generate lift or reduce drag in many different ways. The wings' extraordinary flexibility also allows the animals to make 180-degree turns in a distance of less than half a wingspan. Bats need to be highly agile in the air since most of them, about 70%, feed upon flying insects, including pesky mosquitoes. For bats to pluck tiny mosquitoes from thin air, they need to be able to dash one way and then another in the blink of an eye. And as you probably know, bats sleep upside down, often hanging from the high ceilings in caves. How does a bat go from flying right side up to an upside down stationary position in only a fraction of a second? They literally flip themselves in mid-flight like a talented acrobat and quickly attach their bottom claws to the rocky cave ceiling. One bat enthusiast described this flight to perch position as performing a high dive backwards, as in reversing the whole process. Amazing. Perhaps most impressive about bats, especially the category of bats that scientists call microbats, is that they navigate through the air and hunt their prey at night using their superb auditory system. But they don't merely listen for their prey. They use an extraordinary built-in guidance system called biosonar, or more commonly, echolocation. Microbats are nocturnal, sleeping during the day and hunting at night. Though bats have good eyesight, seeing in complete darkness, such as in caves, is quite difficult or just plain impossible. Thus, microbats rely heavily on their built-in amazing echolocation abilities, which allow them to map out their surroundings in their brains by the echoes they hear. These bats navigate through the darkness and locate things, even flying insects, by making high-pitched sound waves beyond human ability to hear that travel away from the bat, which then hit something, whether a wall, an insect, or a piece of fruit, and then bounce back to the bat. The bat then uses its perfectly designed ears, often big ears, to hear even the faintest of echoes. By the way, bats do make various sounds that people can hear, such as when they're frustrated or excited, but the ultrasonic sounds bats make to echolocate things are too high of a pitch or frequency for humans to hear. Depending on the echo, a bat can determine all sorts of things in only a fraction of a second. It can accurately detect the size, shape, and even texture of objects. A bat's ears, the ultrasonic sounds it makes, and its echo-sensing abilities are so well designed and effective that a bat can determine how far away something is, if that something is moving, and if so, what direction it's going. Microbats can use echolocation to detect and eat insects as small and light as gnats, plucking them right out of the air. They can detect, seize, and eat literally thousands of tiny insects every night. So who should we thank for these high-flying acrobats with built-in biosonar capabilities? Who gets the credit for designing an animal that helps humans greatly with pest control, as well as pollinating hundreds of different species of plants, many of which produce the fruit we eat, including bananas, avocados, and mangoes? In short, where did bats come from? Though atheistic evolutionists claim that bats evolved from flightless mammals tens of millions of years ago, they admit that the fossil record has no record of bat evolution. In fact, bats just appear in the fossil record as bats. One evolutionist wrote several years ago, "For use in understanding the evolution of vertebrate flight, the early record of bats is disappointing. Their most primitive or earliest representatives are fully transformed as capable flyers." Another evolutionist wrote, "The evolution of bats is a mystery because at one time there are no bats, and then all of a sudden, bat fossils can be discovered all over the world." He went on to say, "No transitional protobat that was halfway between a land creature and a flying creature has been discovered." Not only is there no trace of bat evolution in the fossil record, the complex functional design of the bat logically demands an intelligent designer. How could an animal as remarkable as the bat come into being without a brilliant engineer? If there was no intelligent designer to give the first bat its jaw-dropping, fully functional flying skills, its ultrasonic sound-making abilities, its ultra-sensitive auditory system, and its overall navigating abilities, then how did the first bat ever get all of these complex functional skills? Did accidental evolution miraculously bring about bats and their brilliant abilities without a miracle worker? In truth, a bat's intricate design begs for a brilliant designer.